Question 10. Topic: Aggregate turnover. Should the aggregate turnover be determined specific to the GSTN? Answer: No. Aggregate turnover requires consolidation of the turnovers of multiple GSTNs registered under the same PAN on all India basis. Subsection 6 of Section 2 of the CGST Act defines the term aggregate turnover. It means the aggregate value of all the taxable supplies, exempt supplies, export of goods or services, and interstate supplies also, and of persons having the same PAN to be computed on all India basis. That is why we need to consolidate the various turnovers of the GSTN issued under the same PAN for the purpose of determining the aggregate turnover. Let's take this illustration. Happy Client Private Limited has 4 registrations in India. The state-wise turnover is given below. Karnataka, rupees 5 crores, Maharashtra, rupees 1 crore, Gujarat, rupees 3 crores, and Rajasthan, rupees 1 crore. Now, to compute the aggregate turnover with respect to each of the state, we need to sum up the aggregate turnovers of all these states for that matter, the turnovers of all these states, which will come up to 10 crores. So for each of this GSTN, the aggregate turnover will be rupees 10 crores. Why is this aggregate turnover relevant? It has the relevance in the 4 provisions majorly, which is discussed here with application of the registration provisions, the threshold which is specified for the registration. For that, we need to consolidate the aggregate turnovers. Reporting of the number of HSN digits, you know, up to 1.5 crores, no need to comply with the HSN. From 1.5 crores to 5 crores, 2 digits HSN compliance is required, and above 5 crores, it is 4 digit. That is why we need to appropriately compute the aggregate turnover. Again, for the GST requirement, up to 2 crores, there is no requirement for the GST audit. And for the financial year 18-19, in fact, there has been an enhancement of this limit of aggregate turnover to up to 5 crores. There is no requirement for GST audit. And written filing, there is an option of quarterly and monthly, especially with respect to this GSTR1. Again, there the criteria is the aggregate turnover. If we look at the COVID related measures which has been provided by the government in the form of relaxations, various aggregate turnover thresholds have been fixed up, like up to 1.5 crores, 1.5 to 5 crores and above 5 crores. So in all these cases, the understanding of the concept of aggregate turnover would be very much relevant, and it has to be appropriately computed and related compliances must be ensured. Thank you.